In this lecture, we will see the carrier mobility in semiconductors. We know that mobility mu can be written as Vd by E, where Vd is the drift velocity. And E is the applied electric field. From here, it simply means how quickly charge carriers can move inside a crystal. Without collision. So mobility simply means how quickly charge carriers can move inside a crystal without any collision. And by putting the value of Vd and E, we can also write mu that is equal to E into tau by m star. So this is the equation that we are going to use in this lecture. From here, we can see that mu is equal to charge into tau by m star, where tau is relaxation time. Between two collision, or its mean free time and m star is the effective mass. Of the carrier. If carriers are electrons, then we can put here Me star, and if carriers are holes, then we can put H here, that is M star. So from this equation, we can see that mobility depends upon three factors. We can simply see that mobility is equal to E, tau and by M star. So these are three factors that can affect this mobility. So these factors are, first, relaxation time. That is tau. Second one, effective mass. That is M star. And the third one is charge on the carriers. It means type of material. Is it P type or N type? So if we see all these three factors, we can conclude that in general, M star and E, that is type of material, are fixed for a given sample or material, whatever you want to say. And therefore, mobility depends upon relaxation time only. That is tau. And this relaxation time can be affected by scattering of charge carrier in a crystal. So from this equation we can see that mobility depends upon these three factors, that is E, tau and M star, and in this equation these two factors E and M star are fixed for a given sample. So it means here mobility is only dependent on tau, relaxation time, and this relaxation time we know that depends upon the scattering of the charge carriers. If there are more scattering, then this relaxation time is small. And if scattering are very low, then this relaxation time will be long. So and we know that there are two types of scattering first one scattering due to lattice vibration and the second scattering due to ionized impurity. So these are two scatterings in a crystal or in a semiconductor, and this scattering can affect the relaxation time, and that again can affect the mobility of the charge carriers. So first I am going to explain this scattering due to lattice vibration. So simply, if we increase temperature, crystal vibrations or crystal start to vibrate in a periodic fashion. At some parts of the crystal, crystal molecules compress each other and at some other parts they move away from each other. This will increase the amplitude of atomic vibrations. At some point they compress each other at and some points they move away from each other. So in this way the amplitude of the atomic vibrations will increase. So if the temperature is further increased, then the scattering due to lattice vibration will also increase. And probability of collision of electron or charge carrier will increase. That will reduce the value of time between two successive collisions that is tau, and tau will reduce मोबिलिटी सो एज वी इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर एंड ड्यू टू दिस इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन और चार्ज कैरियर विल इंक्रीज दैट विल रिड्यूस द वैल्यू ऑफ द रिलैक्सेशन टाइम एंड दिस रिडक्शन इन द रिलैक्सेशन टाइम विल रिड्यूस द मोबिलिटी सो नाउ लेट्स कंसिडर द टेम्परेचर डिपेंडेंस ऑफ टाउ सिंस ड्यू टू इंक्रीज इन द टेम्परेचर टाउ इज गोइंग टू डिक्रीज सो लेट्स कंसिडर दिस कंसेप्ट इन डिटेल So let's consider there are two atoms this is atom first and this is second And these are vibrating. And this is the amplitude of their vibration. Let's say it's A. This is also and if the distance between these two is L then if an electron E that comes in contact to this atom let's say here then this atom will scatter this electron in this direction and let's say this velocity is u then again this electron will get scattered by this atom in this direction so this is a complete scattering process between these two atoms and the time between this point and this point is known as relaxation time and this is velocity v so this length should be equal to u tau so the which is l is known as here mean free path tau as I said earlier mean free time between two successive collision or it's just you can say relaxation time and this area, that is with radius A or amplitude A, is S. So here cross sectional area S which is equal to pi a square. So if a charge carrier comes in this cross sectional area, then that charge carrier will get reflected or get scattered in another direction by this atom. And here A is the amplitude of lattice vibration . So now I am writing this complete steps here for your better understanding. That is, an electron with mean speed u is scattered when its path crosses the cross sectional cross-sectional area S of a scattering center. And the scattering center may be a vibrating atom and impurity vacancy or some other defect. Since relaxation time tau is the mean time taken between two successive collisions, then the mean free path that is denoted by L is u tau. So this is the value of mean free path, and let me denote it. And if NS is the concentration of scattering centers then in the volume SL there is one scattering in this volume there is one scattering center that is we can write that is S L N S equal to 1 and or we can also write it as S we know what is the value of L that is U tau and S equal to 1. So from here this mean free time relaxation time tau is given by from here it is equal to 1 by S U N S. So this is the value of relaxation time. And please note that here mean speed of the carrier of the electron is also called as thermal velocity and in some books this U may be written as UTH or VTH. TH means thermal velocity. So, but in by above equation, that is what is the cross sectional area, we know that S equal to pi a square. So, by putting this value in this equation, we can write tau equal to 1 by pi a square into u. We can also write uth, but I am writing it u only. Ns. So this is the value of relaxation time between two successive collisions. And from here we can see that tau is inversely proportional to the area of or area pi a square that scatters the electron. Here I am using electron, but you can use hole also, or we can also use the word carrier instead of electron here. That is when electrons path crosses pi a square, it gets scattered. So here tau is inversely proportional to the area of cross sectional of the scattering center. And by considering thermal vibration of the atoms as simple harmonic motion, then the average kinetic energy of the oscillation is given by that is kinetic energy, which is equal to 1/4 m a square omega square and here omega is the frequency of the oscillation and a is the amplitude of that oscillation, m is the mass. And this kinetic energy and this kinetic energy according to the kinetic theory of gases or matter, matter is equal to 1/2 kT. That is, this 1/2 m a square omega square is equal to 1/2 kT. And if you remember kinetic theory of gases, that the kinetic energy in one dimension is 1/2 kT and in three dimension is 3 kT. So this energy is equal to this. So from here we can see that this a square is directly proportional to T. So here we can see that a square directly proportional to t. We don't need here omega square or m, we only need this a square. So here a square is directly proportional to t. It means 1 by or the cross sectional area pi a square is also directly proportional to t, which is s. And here pi a square is directly proportional to 1 by t. And in our equation of tau, we know that tau equal directly proportional to 1 by pi a square. This means tau inversely proportional to 1 by t. So here we get first equation, that is tau is inversely proportional to t. Or relaxation time is inversely proportional to t. If we increase the temperature, then relaxation time will decrease, and vice versa. And we know that an electron in the conduction band or hole in the valence band is free to wander around. Therefore, has only kinetic energy. Since an electron in conduction band or hole in valence band free to wander around the conduction band, it means it has only kinetic energy. And we know that the mean kinetic energy per electron in the conduction band is 3 by 2 kT. This energy here, this energy only in one dimension, but here I am using kinetic energy in three dimensions. So we can write it as 3 kT. So, and we know that what is kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is half me star u square, which is equal to 3 by 2 kT. Here we can get the information about u, that how u depends upon t. So from here we can see that u square directly proportional to t. It means u directly proportional to t raised to the power half. So from here we use this proportionality of velocity with time, with temperature. So ultimately we can write tau, that is relaxation time, which is equal to pi a square into u into ns is directly proportional to 1 by t and t raised to the power half, and since we know the actual number of this ns, so we don't need to get an expression with t, and it doesn't depend upon temperature here. So it means tau is directly proportional to t raised to the power minus 3 by 2. So this is the power. And since here we are using lattice vibration, so this tau is related to lattice vibration, so I am writing it as tau L, or we can write here that tau L is the relaxation time due to lattice vibrations. Which leads to a lattice scattering limited mobility as so here this mobility, that is directly proportional to temperature or t raised to the power minus 3 by 2. So this is the mobility due to lattice scattering. So here we can see that the mobility that is limited by lattice vibrations or lattice scattering is directly proportional to the t raised to the power minus 3 by 2. So I am finishing it here, and in the next lecture we will see the scattering due to ionized impurities, and we will see the total mobility due to scattering by lattice vibrations and scattering by ionized impurities.